Okay, we're here with two really neat people here, Julie and Jacob, and they're from the Hawaiian Islands, and they've been on the Terrain Modification Program now for about 5 years. And we're going to talk about some of their transformation, some of their turbulence, some of the people in their lives that they've actually helped for the better, because all it is really following through some of the different protocols that are at your fingertips on the internet. And that's what they did. This is the first time I've ever met Julie and Jacob. And they've been studying on their own, investigating and experiencing a multitude of different ways to be able to get healthy. So let's do a brief introduction. And they're a married couple, which is great because you have two different people that can work with each other. I always say you need a companion, and if you don't have a companion, it's a lot harder. You'll see. So terrain modification also has to do with one side helping the other side when the one side doesn't feel like doing what you know you are on protocol or program to do, and that's actually to change your life to a higher vibrational tune. Terrain modification, remember, has 20 different parts, as we talk about in the lectures. And some of it has to do with changing your emotional status. Some of it's your mental status. Some of it's your physical status. Some of it's just getting into the sun, getting more oxygen, remineralizing your body, learning the booby traps like plastics, heavy metals, and all different things that realistically are not known, like taking a shower every day sometimes when you're showering in chloramines or chlorine. So terrain modification is something that you don't learn overnight. And once you start to learn it, you really start to see the world as what it is. It's really not that smart. Even though we feel we live in a smart world, we live in a world sometimes that's too smart because we're not smart enough to be able to see what it's doing to us for convenience. So, you know, you guys have actually lost a tremendous amount of weight, too. How many of you lost? 50 pounds, I think you said, Jacob?
Yeah, about 50 pounds.
50 pounds. Wow. And 50 pounds, remember, is not fat. We call that baggage. I lost like 40 pounds, same thing. It's body weight that your body doesn't need because most of it has nothing to do with being muscle. It has to do with being toxicity and microbial complexities, as I call it. And then, Julie, how much did you?
I lost 20 pounds.
Choo-hoo! So, and he's got some great pictures we'll show you of what he used to look like with 50 pounds. The person who's actually filming this right now, how many pounds have you lost, David?
Over 70, close to 90 pounds.
Okay, let's just say 70 pounds. That's a massive amount of weight that we don't call body fat. We call it a lot of different creatures that are on your nervous system that are making you not you. So once you really start to rid yourself of a lot of these creatures, what happens is you get clarity. You know, tell me some of the different ideas. How did you even get involved in any of this stuff?
I would say about 5-6 years ago, after a concussion injury, I went to a traditional doctor and they gave me medication for the concussion, and that really messed my system up. And then it was go to rehabilitation, go to physical therapy, and then you're on your own. And I was like, gosh, doc, you know, I'm not really myself like I was before. And they're like, no, you're healed. Don't you know? Yeah. So you're better. But I was so much worse. And I went into just that basic level of food, always hungry. And I knew that this wasn't how I was before. And she started kind of following me down the rabbit hole the wrong way. So I started searching and really doing a lot of research. And that's when I started train modifying myself, not knowing that that's what it was called, so to speak. And just started working my way up the food pyramid like you talk about.
And well, I mean, how did you get introduced into this? You saw one of my crazy videos. Did you hear from someone else? I mean, how did you just bump onto the internet and
really, I just bumped on the internet. I think it was a rah-rah video or something, and they were talking about, they were interviewing
Dr. Bizarre.
Yeah, and I was just like listening, and I listened to some of the other videos, and from some of the other things I've done in work, it really resonated with the system and how it was talking about the alkalinity of the body and the pH and the different superfoods. And we were really, really, I was really drawn to it because it really resonated as true, and it was simple, straightforward.
And the information's right there.
And it was free. So I could watch the videos as I was kneading and something new, and we started making kombucha, and we started doing the different drinks and switching things over. And
so did you do this first, and you had to drag Julie into it, or did this something that she just sort of fought?
I was learning anthropology in school, and I was reading about different cultures and why people eat what they eat when they eat, and really get into just the cultural and social conditioning of our food. So I started researching about milk and finding out that most people are lactose intolerant, and then watching your videos, so it kind of tied in all together and made sense to me. And just doing simple things like taking dairy out of our diet and drinking almond milk instead, or having quinoa instead of rice, just simple things in the beginning, and we saw a difference right away.
Absolutely, yeah, the simple substitutions. You make it easy, these are the healthier options. And
so you did this sort of like your family that you did, and once you got to, I know, once you got some really good results out of this, you tried to push these ideas onto your family, which really sometimes, I know it's hard on my family, and it does take a while for people to be able to really see, because I know you guys really went out of your way. You made a whole like different
PowerPoint
pictures of before and afters, and simple steps just to be able to take, just to engage yourself in this new, because what you're really trying to do is get on a heirloom, which really means that the food has not been perverted by science yet, and trying to get on a hydrational liquid diet at first, just so you can rid yourself of all the stuck stuff that sticks inside you. And you know, did you go through turbulence though when you as far as did you feel that what you were doing maybe wasn't right because your body was complaining, or did you just sort of work through it?
I think you start thinking about all the cravings, you know, it's once you start taking out the bad food or the food with additives, things that make you crave them, you start feeling withdrawals in a way. But learning how to substitute coffee for blue-green algae water, just simple things that give you what you need, and putting the healthy in and taking the bad stuff out, that help with the turbulence.
So do you notice that, let's say, you've been doing this for how long now?
5 years.
Doing the liquids, strictly your liquid program for about a little over a year, but moving up the pyramid for about 5 years.
Okay. So the pyramid actually made sense to you, and that was one of the lectures.
Absolutely.
Yeah, where you're starting, if you haven't seen this is really good for, you know, this is an interview for, the reason being I like to do these interviews is because a picture's worth 1,000 words, and a video that has a testimonial that actually other people can jump into really gives us 1,000 new players to get healthy, wealthy, happy, and wise. And the big picture of what we're really trying to do here is not just get healthy, trying to evolve yourself. And evolution of yourself really is a priceless idea once you get healthy. Because remember, 80% of the population of the United States is 15 pounds plus overweight. So let's say if you lost 20 pounds and you lost 50 pounds, you're in that average. You're not in the average anymore. I saw, you know, took these guys to Akaka Falls running. They keep up, they push right through versus the average person that would have all that extra baggage, and they haven't trained their system to be able to capture 30% oxygen like at Akaka Falls, would feel very sick. We took you to yoga. Okay, I saw you're very strong, both you guys. Okay, and you've been doing exercise along with this also too. It's not just the foods. You've been terrain modifying different parts of yourself. You've been reading, you've been studying, and some of the things you told me you've been studying too are actually things that would help the world in its evolution versus maybe studying the art of war. So do you feel that you're more evolved than you were previously when you were, and as far as you see more, remember a lot of things we talked about.
Yeah, I think a lot of things become clearer when you get off a lot of the food, because the food have lots of preservatives and chemicals, and you don't realize how many things you're addicted to, how many layers of addiction, whether it's caffeine, MSG, high fructose corn syrup. So as you modify off of them and make positive substitutions, you really notice your mind changes, the way you think. I would never have thought I would have been a vegetarian 3-4 mm-hmm. years ago, and just that alone, the way it changes the way your mind thinks. My eyes have changed color. My skin has kind of changed. So
no, you guys have really super good skin. You can tell. Yeah. Okay, like I said, where's your makeup? She goes, I don't wear any. I said, boy, you got what every woman wants, not to wear makeup. And once you really take out a lot of the junk out of your system, your skin really has vitality to it. Cleaning your skin. I did gua sha on Jacob the other day. We made him look like he got bullwhipped a little bit there, but didn't hurt though.
No.
Okay. And we did some what's called acid reduction massage or lymphatic drainage massage. And you know, these are things that are more advanced, but you'll learn them as you go, because this is something that I call self-treatment. And self-treatment's really, you did this to yourself. I didn't help you. You helped yourself. Because there's hundreds of videos we have on the internet. And just like in earthshiftproject.com, it's a lifestyle makeover community. There's thousands of people from around the world that trade ideas and just give people inspiration. And I hope that this is one of the reasons being why we do these interviews, is to give other people inspiration to say, I can do this myself. I don't have to go to a doctor to get a diet. It just has to be reasonable and logical. That's why I call it the biological way of life. It's natural. What types of turbulences did you feel that you guys went through? Did you have a relationship turbulence a little bit when you actually started to? Because a lot of times when you start beating on your microbes a little bit and you don't feed them, remember, did you notice also that you guys were irritated with each other or anything? Because this is sometimes some people, I always say, if that happens in your relationship, then you exercise. You're not exercising that. Do you guys have any of that type of?
I don't think between the two of us. I notice it more with my family, because mm-hmm. we're really close to my mother and my stepfather, and they live in California, so we're always talking on the phone, and we were telling what they were doing, and we started noticing that was different, mm-hmm. and that's when we made the PowerPoint. We're like, hey, you got to do this, and
sure.
And my stepfather was diagnosed diabetic and had Hashimoto's disease, and my mother was overweight, and they're getting older and really lethargic, and I'm just like. I started sending him the superfoods, and we made the protocol, and we called him every day like their coach. Mm-hmm. We're like, are you doing it? You're taking the kombucha? How are you feeling? We started walking him through it. And then that really, they started getting on the same page as us. And my mom lost maybe 40 pounds. And my stepfather lost, I think, like 50, 60 pounds over the course of maybe a year. And he was diagnosed diabetic. And then when he went back after a year, the doctor said he was no longer diabetic. And it really, really helped his Hashimoto's, and he needed to be on that kind of diet. Mm-hmm. So to me, that was huge, and maybe that helped prolong his life. And you know, he might be with us now because of this kind of program. And they're so grateful, and they're so happy that we kind of pulled them along. And they went through more turbulence because I think they're a little bit older.
Mm-hmm. He lost 50 pounds.
I want to say he went from 230.
He came up to me at one.
Oh,
of the,
yeah, he's
the
skinny
lectures.
Now. Yeah.
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 And he says, "Hey, you changed my whole family's life." Yeah. And I just told him the same thing. No, you guys did it yourself, but I didn't know that you were the kickstarting factor. See. My relationships that I've ever had were never with the people I was doing my terrain mod. As long as, this is the biggest problem, that if anybody's going to do any of this stuff, if he just did this program, or if you just did it by yourself, you guys would break up. Mm-hmm. Because what happens is that what lives inside you starts to go ahead and say, no, I need the red meat. Oh, I need the wheat, corn, and soy. Oh, I need the white sugar. Oh, you're going to go exercise? I don't want to exercise. So, you know, my hardest relationship was with my family.
Yeah,
and my children, okay, and it's only the children, because they're so programmed on their friends wanting to eat, and they want to feel like they're fitting in. So I always feel it's so important, because if you can get the family to do this and make it fun, that's when you get really good results. So that's pretty good how you got your. So this was on your side of the fence.
Mother and my stepfather.
Okay.
And my biological father has diabetes as well, and he was like, "Oh, I have different kind of diabetes," and so he didn't want to hear it, kind of like you're talking. But you know, my stepfather and my so I saw both. One did and one didn't. My brothers and sisters, they. So.
And then you've done this also with your family on your
side
too.
With my mom mostly. I gave her chia seeds and you know, she told me, oh, they're nothing, they're not going to do anything for me. And then she's like, oh my gosh, I can't believe how many times I'm going to the bathroom. I feel lighter. And I gave her some goji berries to take, and she feels like she has more energy now.
Okay.
I think most of all, she just feels more stable emotionally as well.
And slowly making those little substitutions, and people, you know, the shower dechlorinator and mm-hmm. the mineralized water and the filter.
Changing the makeup yeah. from, you know.
The soap, everything.
Modifying your entire house, you yep. know, with.
And then it's your family, and yeah. then, so it's really...
Yeah, that's why I always tell people, because it's not just terrain modifying of your body, but it's terrain modifying your kitchen. Mm-hmm. It's terrain modifying, that's why your pots and pans with Teflon. You know, we have nano ceramic. I don't use any more, personally, any more silverware, because it's all nickelware. It's not silver, it's nickel. And so I stay away from using any metal as much as I can. And if I'm going to use a bowl, I use glass. You just have to watch out for breaking them, because I do break very easy. And you know, you change your detergents, perfumes. You're in the perfume business before, right?
I was in the cosmetic beauty industry, and after learning what kind of ingredients goes into products, so-called beauty products, to make you more beautiful. Truth is that it actually clogs your pores, your lymph system. You know, and when you accumulate all these toxins and chemicals in your body, you get sick. And so a lot of women don't know that, you know, if you're using aluminum-filled deodorants and things like that, it's actually doing more harm than good.
Well, and you talk about perfumes, just to get in this for a while. Do you use... You used to use perfumes.
Oh, I used to use perfume every day. I used to put perfume on every 15 minutes or so when I would go to a meeting with a certain account executive or go meet mm-hmm. a buyer in a cosmetic industry. And, you know, we felt that was the mm-hmm. thing to do. And
so what did you do to replace the...
I use peppermint oil for under my arms, and mm-hmm. you feel refreshed. You smell nice, and, you know, you don't feel so clogged up. And mm-hmm. I use essential oils, organic oils, because even though it says natural, it can also have preservatives and chemicals that are bad for you. So mm-hmm. I use mostly organic essential oils.
Now, the same with you. Do you use... we used to use perfume, same thing, right? I mean, this is just one little section of terrain.
It's definitely one section. We first switched to the coconut or the shea butter deodorant, aluminum. We've been off aluminum before this program. We knew that. But switching to the natural, I think it's a shea butter you have on your website. That mm-hmm. was nice because, you know, you might, when you're terrain modifying, you definitely, you know, as you detox, you're not going to smell like roses. But now that we've been on the program for so long,
you don't smell anymore. Yeah, there's no
but
smell.
What you smell before was what you ate and your microbes and whatnot.
We're not masking our scent anymore.
Yeah,
exactly. So that was one of the biggest problems that I used to go through, too. When I was in my detoxificational stage, when I was losing my 40 pounds of baggage.
Oh, yeah. You just...
I was stinking. Yeah. And I couldn't figure out... One of the things that is very important in learning a lot of this... Simple. It's just exchanging things and taking a few things out. Like, I don't have any white onions, any green onions, or any garlic, but I'll have purple onions. The three of these, the white onions, the green onions, and the garlic, have what's called sulfone hydroxyl ion, and that's that BO smell that people get. And their bodies not only have this odor, but it comes through their skin, their breath, the top of their hair, if they scratch the top of their head, any area of them, they can smell your fingers, and this poison comes through your skin. It's actually cleans your blood. It does. There's no question. But what it does is it dysfunctionally desynchronizes your mind. So part of actually cleaning up too and getting clear is getting off some of these different things, that chemicals, perfumes, you know, synthetics. Look at a piece of meat, hormones, antibiotics. Now, you did go from meat and you started eating, you said, grass-fed, right?
Yeah, we really, the whole process was really a big experiment, because we were first eating Costco organic chicken. Mm-hmm. And then we were like, okay, let's go next, would be like grass-fed beef. And so we were working out really well. And we both were really fit and working out quite a bit, because we were eating a lot of animals still, you know, about...
But you were understanding the chemicals,
yeah,
though, and the hormones,
so
and antibiotics.
So we would experiment, like, okay, we'll do whole foods, the, you know, the full grass-fed beef and the buffalo bison, the really clean meats. Mm-hmm. do that for a while, notice our body would shrink. We'd get leaner. We weren't puffy. It was cleaner. Mm-hmm. And then when we'd go back to the Costco chicken, like, oh, maybe we don't need it. Then it was like, oh my God, I put on 5 pounds. It wasn't five, maybe 10 pounds. It wasn't muscle.
Swelling.
It was swelling from sodium. And I learned about them injecting the chickens with sodium to make them look puffier and juicier. So then we started really being conscious of the micro adjustments to our diet. And that's kind of simultaneous. I was doing some research on different types of algae. I was doing consulting on nutrient profiles of algae. And then when that just so tied in with what you were talking about with the blue-green algae, and I saw that it was benefiting microorganisms. Plankton was helping them grow faster if you had the right strain and the pH was in the right range.
Exactly.
We applied it to our body, and it was like...
If you feed yourself the best stuff, then you get the best results.
And it just takes a little... So I always say you can give somebody a bad habit in 7 days. It takes you 21 days to sort of bend some of this habit around, because what lives inside you is really what you're bending around. And once you get over each layer, one of the parts of terrain modification, what we've really been putting together these different ideas to make it so it's easier for people to grasp, is they go on 21 days of change. Even if it's going from pork to beef to chicken to fish, the scallops, or just being going, just staying a meat eater like you did, and you actually just got less chemicals, less hormones, less antibiotics, less synthetics, less vaccines. You're going grass-fed. Then, in time, you'll find out that you want to go more towards a plant-based diet because you're really looking to get clean and lean. And you don't have to get skinny. Like this guy's, he's got good muscles on. I watched him. He's got stomach muscles. And Julie, she's not, these guys are on a plant-based diet. They're not weak. A lot of people you'll see, because you guys exercise. You have to do the exercise. If not, you'll see a lot of vegetarians and a lot of people, they're lacking something. They're either lacking B vitamins, they're lacking stressing their muscle fibers or using intensity to be able to actually let them so they can do what they're supposed to do. Because there is a difference when you go from meat over to plant-based. You will go through, did you feel that weakness time frame?
Oh yeah, when we were doing the fertile eggs for a while, when we were just at the end of our meat eating, fertile eggs and chicken, not fertile eggs and fish, I'm sorry. And then we went to just fish. And then when we made, it's been about little, maybe 14 months or so, we've been completely off. And I guess the one booby trap or mistake we kind of made, or the stumbling block, is we didn't substitute with creatine. So I did notice a big drop going completely off of the animal flesh, no eggs, no, totally vegan. Mm-hmm. And then putting the creatine back in, it was instantly strength and energy. So I think that's maybe a mistake a lot of people make.
How did you get that idea with the creatine?
Well, from one of your videos, because I was watching one of your videos and... and you were talking about
it. It's a big booby trap because meat is loaded full of creatine.
Yeah.
And then if you all of a sudden just skip over and go from, you go, oh, well, I'm just going to go vegan or vegetarian.
Yeah.
The vegetables have like super small, like this much creatine versus meat has this much. And creatine, basically, just so you know, that's what makes your muscles so they can fire with power. And if your system doesn't know how to grab out minute particles of creatine out of plants, then you'll get really weak and possibly even get sick. Because a lot of vegetarians, just because you'll see a lot of people that are very mineral deficient being vegetarians because they're not doing it correctly. They didn't do the wean down. And I always tell people, if you can, it's good for you to be able to, if you don't have the creatine either, and I take a small amount of creatine every morning, creatine monohydrate, and I also like to have 2 fertile eggs a day for me because I'm doing a lot of not strenuous exercise, but I work out every day. And in fact, in just a little while, we're going to go do this crazy class over in Hilo. It's called Insanity. And you sweat for about an hour, like 3, 4, 5 pounds of water. And you'll see a lot of people when we do this class, they don't sweat because they're not healthy. And their system overheats, and you'll see them. If you sweat, you can just your radiator actually is cooling you down. But you'll notice some of the people there that don't sweat, and the people that don't sweat, they're like time bombs. They're not really, cleaning the skin because that's part of the protocol.
Yeah. That was huge, especially even in Hawaii when I first moved. I'm pretty white, and I used to always use sunscreen. And then as we started studying your programs and your videos, we started switching. We just took sunscreen out and started using the cleaning.
Mm-hmm.
and even on our face. I always use my face, and it was like, oh my gosh, I'm not burning. I'm in Hawaii, this really, you know, fair guy, and I'm not burning. Walking around with my shirt off, and people, you know, because, oh, you know, no sunscreen. So that's something that you don't have an idea that what's burning is actually what's living on your skin and not you.
And this guy, let me tell you, both these guys, after 3 or 4 or 5 years, what happens is that you get a chance to really see the booby traps that actually you were part of this, I won't say booby traps, but you were part of, I was part of the disease before. I used to drink colas. I used to go ahead and have all these different fast foods, which are actually fake foods. I used to have all these different chemicals that were hidden inside my foods. So the foods that we're eating today may have not been so exciting. So what you have to do is you have to go through this layer by layer, baby step by baby step. But what happens is that this becomes interesting to be able to see how many things are sort of purposely, as you see it, it's sort of purposely put into the system. So we either are controlled in a way, or it's like, I won't say dumbed down, but we're really a species right now that needs to wake up. And so that's why, you know, I really have my, you know, I don't have a hat on, but my hat off to you, to be able to just want to sit in front of this one-eyed monster I call the television here, and be able to really share, because I heard you talking to some of the other people here at the retreat, and you really changed their minds in different ways, because you're way more advanced, both of you guys. You've already gone through a lot of the trenches. You've gone through a lot of this. Now, could you or would you go back to the way you were, knowing that what you know today?
There's no way.
But why?
Also, watching just simple documentaries, like getting off of animal products and just not eliminating health just for health reasons, but when you look at how we treat our animals, you know, and the resources the animals are consuming, and you see this overall picture, and you become more of a conscious eater.
That's what's going to just get at. This is what happens.
When
you start changing, because, you know, Jacob was saying there's a pyramid. And this pyramid has to do with going from the standard American diet, going to healthier foods, from healthier foods to organic foods, from organic foods to what we call heirloom foods. And healthier foods doesn't mean it's good. It just means it's a lot better than the standard American diet, which means if it's on sale, you'll get it. And standard American diet is where all pretty much disease starts. And if you stay in it, oh yes, you will get one for sure. There's no question. So remember, there are 50 million diabetics, and it's actually more than that now, but we'll just stay with the old statistics. In the United States, there's 30% of the population that's obese. We're now the second obese nation in the world. The number one is, do you know which one it is?
Mexico.
Is Mexico. 32.87% of the population is 30 pounds plus overweight. We're 31. We're right behind them, though. So, and what have you noticed? The biggest thing that you notice sometimes also through this terrain modification, you used to probably, because you're 50 pounds and 20 pounds, means you used to eat a lot of sugar too. You know, you had to have a lot of sweet.
I have to think back. It's been so long. But yeah, of course I was addicted to sugar. I was addicted to all kinds of food. Mm-hmm. You were unconsciously eating for the sake of eating. And I think that's the biggest thing. Like when you said, would you go back? No, I'm free from this food dependency. Mm-hmm. And people go, oh, my friends will be like, oh, don't you want to eat this? Don't you want a diversity? And it's like, I'm driving a Ferrari. I'm going on jet fuel. I don't want to jump back to a Pinto. I mean, you like to go between a Pinto and a Honda Accord.
Exactly.
I'm in a fighter jet. I mean, that's how good I feel. The food's so clean. I used to get such upset stomach and headaches.
Thinking that was normal.
Yeah, thinking it's normal. Oh, I'm just getting older. I had acid pain in my joints after working out. And it's like, if you could feel for 5 minutes, once you get off all of the dependencies, it's like, wow, what was I doing this whole time? Thinking I was healthy. Because at every level you think, you're like, oh no, I'm not, da, da, da. And then you go a little bit more and you're just like getting better and better.
So did it take you, how many, you've been on this 5 years now.
I would say at least 5 years to get to here. The last year is where we really turn on the superfoods, you know, really.
No animals.
100% yeah. Vegetarian.
Yes, you slowly weaned it down.
Yeah, we had to work our way up. There wasn't. I don't think you really have to take your time. And maybe some people go faster, maybe people go slower, but don't be in a rush. And if you have backslide. You know, I hear a lot of people say, oh, so-and-so was raw, now they eat cooked food. It's not about that. It's not about a dogma. It's about you freeing yourself and you feeling the best. You know, Ralph Smart always says the greatest version of yourself. You know, to me, this is feeling vital, feeling energetic, being the greatest version of yourself. And that's what this program has really helped us become.
Well, and I see you guys have super vitality, too.
We weren't like this before.
Yeah, no, you have super vitality. And this is one of like the side effects, is what I call, of changing your world, is that you have more energy than everybody else. And everybody says, what are you guys on?
Yeah.
What are you taking?
Yeah, you're on caffeine.
Yeah.
You're on energy.
Are you taking pharmaceuticals? Are you going to the doctor? They're giving you like one of those little pills to make you so you're a little more energetic?
No.
Your vibrational tune right now is more of you than it ever has been. Because when you're like, let's say you're part of that 32% of the obese people. Those are billions of creatures that are calling to eat sugar all the time. And they do go to the bathroom inside the body, and they cause our blood levels to get more acid, our oxygen levels to get more acid. So what do you do? Just get tired. So right now, do you see, this is what happened with me too. Sugar used to be something that used to be in my world. I used to even go through, 10 years ago, I used to go through a quart of maple syrup a week myself in my tea that used to be an acid type of really not good tea for me. Now what I use is I don't really like sugar anymore.
Yeah.
I like oils and I like good mineralized salt. So that's like to me, like my dessert, like an avocado with a little chlorella, maybe, and a little bit of salt on top. I mean, to me, that's like dessert versus before maybe a donut or ice cream. I used to have ice cream every night for years. That used to be, and I mean, well, this is a while ago. I'm 53 years old. And I would say, you know, the same thing. If I asked myself, could I ever go back? Sure, I could if I want to not be able to go to the bathroom. And I'm talking about as you get older, if you don't go to the bathroom, there's nothing worse than not being able to go to the bathroom. And I used to have the worst stomach problems. I had colitis, diverticulitis. I had blood in my stools all the time. I even thought I had stomach cancer because I just couldn't go to the bathroom. My stomach would lock up. I never would eat out because if I did, I'd have stomach problems for 3 days. So people used to say, hey, let's go out to dinner. And I said, no, I can't. I don't want to go out because, oh, you just don't want to spend the money. No, I'm serious. If I go out, I'm going to be, you know, I'm going to have stomach problems for 3 days. But I didn't know how to change my diet back then. And this was like 15 years ago. So, you know, for me to be able to really share with people, and just like you're sharing with right now, if this can be done very easy in 180 days. And that's why I call it, you know, the 180-day terrain modification program. That's phase one. Then you go through, this isn't something you do when you're just, it's a lifestyle makeover. You're changing your food, your liquids. I mean, you're really trying to wash things out because your body is 18 gallons of salt water. It's liquid. It's not what we think. It's not solid. It's really liquid. So one of the best things you've noticed, though, is probably having a lot of variety of different liquids, right?
Oh, yeah. All the different drinks, the hibiscus and
the liquids of vitality.
Kombucha we're making now. And
make your own kombucha.
Yeah. Drinking your Bomonte tea instead of coffee.
Which has more power anyways, but at least it's an alkaline form of caffeine, which really is detoxificational. You know, one of the things, because people are thinking sometimes, this is a booby trap, just because it's yerba mate doesn't mean that it's good for you, because there's also yerba mate that's smoked. You don't want to use smoked yerba mate, or you'll read on the internet that yerba mate is not good for you. Well, that's true, as long as it's, if it's smoked, it will not be good for you because it's got polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, which is like a charcoal residue that is in the tea. Because a lot of times when you go to these countries that dry it, they dry it with some weird wood sometimes, pallets, just whatever wood they can get. Okay, so ours is sun-dried, and you have to be very smart. Salt's not good for you. It's not. The doctor's right. Regular sodium chloride salt is terrible for you, dries you out. But, sodium chloride with the 80 minerals, and it's in a crystal form like the Himalayan salt, is essential for you because your body needs conductivity. So a lot of times people are doing liquids and they start they start demineralizing themselves, because remember, you know, eating meat, there are a lot of minerals in the flesh. There is a lot of vitamins in the flesh, so you have to be smart to make sure you have the right supplementation. And once you get over this hump of you know, from transmuting yourself from one system to another, you will feel the vitality in this. And all you can do is, I see you guys, you want to share to people, you know, really your change. And that's one of the things that I'd like to have you, what do you think was the hardest thing for you to be able to you know, to get where you're at today when you're doing this? It's just learning the information, or was it just?
I think once I was at my bottom, it was just, I knew it was gonna be a downslide. Like, I was older, I was in my late 20s, and I was in my early 30s, I don't know. Yeah, early 30s.
You feel then. Like you're in your 20s.
Yeah, but like I knew that it's like, you see all your friends and your family gaining weight, and it's like, mm-hmm. you see where that road leads, and you're like, I don't want to go down that road, and there has to be another way. And that's really where it's like I started just devouring the information and going through the videos and applying it. And then I started seeing results and talking to friends and like, hey, watch this video or try this product. And a lot of people would just be like, oh, I got this product. What do you think of this? And you look at it and you're like, okay, this is irradiated, this is not organic. You know, just go to Earthshift, and it's like you compare the products, Earthshift prices versus the other stores, not that there's anything bad with them. It's just you've done all of the research for everyone, and you've been...
The information's laid out.
Yeah, and all the products have been selected as the highest grade available at the best price, so you don't have to run all over the place going to multiple stores. It's like, mm-hmm. this is the best we can find right now, and if we find something better, we'll put it on the website. And that's what's so great about the company and the system, is like, it's constantly improving. So when you find something better, it's like, you're sharing that with us, and it's like, hey, try this new seaweed extract, and then... So it's an evolving system, and you can grow with it as much as you want, but just know you're cheating yourself by trying to take a shortcut and being like, oh, I like this, I don't want to bag any companies, but finding a product that's not maybe as clean, or it's not as pure, or because I did try a lot of
companies.
Yeah,
you don't get anything out of doing anything with shit.
Yeah, I have nothing to do with the company, but people always, you know, always people joke like, you know, why are you pushing this company? I'm pushing this company because they're ethical, honest, and they're putting forth free information. I have friends that pay hundreds of dollars a session to go to a personal trainer, and I'm like, well, you could have got 10 times more information just watching this free video. Mm-hmm. But they, you know, not everyone's ready for that, and they don't, sometimes if it's free, they think it's not valuable. But the information is hugely transformative and life-changing.
When you're ready.
Yeah, when you're ready for it.
When you're ready.
And it's contagious, and if you do it, and you can just go as far as you want.
And you know, the idea, too, to doing this is it that, like I was saying, see, these guys are lucky because they have, like, a companionship here. You have to feel, part of the terrain modification and learning this information is at least to be able to have someone else you can share it with. Because that's how you really learn it too, is you don't just listen to it, and you know, you have to experience it, and then you have to have someone else to be able to, once you see that both people really, or your partner, your companion, whoever, rises to the occasion of better health, wealth, and happiness, then you go, shoot, I need to share, you know, I need to share them with my friends, it's different. See, the big plus also is for people to see is the packaging that you have to be very careful of, because you could actually have an organic substance and put it in a leaching plastic mess. Or, you know, there's a lot of things being sold now in cans that are organic, because people just know the organic buzzword and they think mm-hmm. it's organic, but they don't know that the can's full of bisphenol A. You don't eat anything out of a can if you can. So, you know, it's an evolving, like you said, work in progress. And see, what I like to do is have other people that are helping us. It's helping us evolve this whole system here. These guys are really part of the work in progress here too, because I like to bend a lot of the things we're doing depending on what I can't see. I have to go ahead and be able to see, you know, what videos, what different things that we're doing to be able to make it so other people feel not comfortable, but they can actually really stay on the program. Because once you stay on for a couple of years, you're there. Mm-hmm. You really are. You know, there is definitely like a social thing here, because that's sort of weird. Tell me about some of the different, because that's one of the, you know, I know I have this problem. I have, you know, when I'm hanging around my social friends, I stop going out to dinner with them and stuff, because all of a sudden they'd look and say, oh, shoot, Robert's here. I can't have a T-bone steak. Yeah. I got to have a bloody veggie burger.
Yeah. I think that's one of the, like you were saying, I think that's one of the hardest things, or the things that we noticed is with our friends, our family, and also cultural too. They're like, oh, it's culturally, you know, why don't you eat this food that your grandmother makes? Or, you know, and finding out that it's not, you know, good for your health. And, you know, when you bring chia seeds to work with goji berries or blue-green algae, and you're drinking that instead of having whatever they have for lunch, you know, at McDonald's. And, you know, sometimes you get looked at like, you know, you're weird or what are you doing? But slowly but surely they'll come around and they'll be like, oh, what is that? How do you feel after drinking that or eating that? And then, you know, everybody else, sometimes they'll come up and they'll say, oh, you know, we bought chia seeds, or, oh, I tried goji berries the other day. But you definitely feel like you're kind of alone in a sense, but having the Earth Shift community and, you know, seeing what other people go through and encouraging each other makes you feel like you're not alone and you're not doing this by yourself.
And that's why I put that community together, because a lot of people told me, said, you know what, I'd like to ask other people that are on this program, you know, how did they get over the hump? How did they get through with their family's turbulence? And I found out, unless your whole family is pretty much on this, because you guys both live in the same house, but if you had, you know, let's say brothers and sisters living with you, have different stuff in your refrigerator, different smells and different things that you're doing, it's hard for you to change. You know, it really is. So the more people that actually want to commit to the program of getting healthy is only because, and all it has to be really is one person that wants to read the material and get it down. Once the other people start to see that this is fun, they want to learn too. But it does take, how many hours? Because you've seen a lot of documentaries and different things. Those helped you out, I'm sure, a lot too.
Yeah, we've a lot, like.
Yeah, I mean, that's
hours,
really
that's
really what's made this change make sense to you too, right? Because what you're doing is not just a fad; it's not a cult, sure.
No.
It's a culture, you know, to be able to really live a clean life. I call this the naturalistic lifestyle too. You're just staying away from chemicals, hormones, antibiotics, and a lot of things that once you find out aren't good for you, you say, I can't eat that because I don't want to pollute myself, especially since you just cleaned yourself.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense. So, let's see. Tell me about some of the health pluses that you found out that you've changed from, you know, remember at some point in time, you don't even know you're sick or sick and tired. Right now you have to think back and say, that's the way I used to feel all the time. You know, go in the bathroom maybe once every couple of days, or I just remember sitting on the toilet myself and my stomach was so bad all the time. And I had no idea why. And this was, you know, back in my 20s. You know, like I said, that was 25 years ago, but it's taken me a long time to figure out how people can actually self-treat themselves, because that's the whole idea. You know, you go to most doctors, you go to most people, you're hearing a different story everywhere. What made you, you know, feel that this story was the correct story? And once you sort of see that this story is correct, I mean, looking back at your normal life, of sort of misery. You get used to misery every day. You know, you get used to, I used to eat pork every morning and bacon every morning. And I'd have meat 3 times a day just because I thought it was good for me. I really did. I mean, when I was cleaning myself out originally, I had gallstones, kidney stones, you know, all these are just like physical problems, physical things. Do you have any physical ailments right now as far as any what's called doctor-related problems?
No, not at all.
Are you on any medications?
No.
No.
Now, one of the things I just like to, like I said previously before, what do you think, what was like the number one negative thing you, let's say when you were 50 pounds overweight, you didn't even know it back then because you were just normal.
I was hot and sweaty all the time, upset stomach, acid in the joints. I still have achy feet a little bit. That's something that hasn't cleared up yet, but.
That'll work on when we start doing all this acid reduction.
It's not going to happen like magically. You don't realize you have something that's not perfectly flowing until you clear up something else. Mm-hmm. And then you're like, oh, okay, that's not, you know, like we go to yoga now and it's like, oh, I can't do the splits yet. You know, that's the kind of stuff you start to work on. It's like, how flexible can you get? Versus before, it's like, can I touch my toes? Or gosh, my stomach hurts. I'm constipated. And you just, like, I was like you, I was eating meat. I was lifting, at this point, I was really lifting weights and I was eating, you know, all this chicken and, you know, doing like the Arnold Schwarzenegger thing. And I was really, you know, much bigger, muscular, but I couldn't go to the bathroom and, you know, my arms hurt. And I was on so much pre-workout drinks, and even that was from the healthier food store being packaged as health food, and I was taking it. I wasn't doing myself a favor. I was, you know, I was kind of going backwards or sideways at best. Mm-hmm. And then once discovering your program and you talked about all the different things, and I was drinking coffee, and, you know, I loved Kona coffee and I still love the smell of it. And when you get clean, it's like, you know, you can almost breathe in the smell.
And you get just as much gratitude as not even eating it.
It's like smelling beautiful flowers. I don't need to eat the flowers to appreciate them.
Exactly.
You smell the Kona coffee. And
that's what I notice now.
Yeah.
I smell things and all of a sudden I feel like I get satisfied just from smelling them versus before I had to have some.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's the biggest, besides physically feeling like I'm in my 20s again, and just feeling like I...
Yeah, but you even look it, though, too. You don't feel it. I mean, you guys have super vitality, never lazy. Yeah. I mean, you're like I said, your skin is really glowing and looks really good. You know, you guys don't have a wrinkle on your face.
Okay. That's gone away, a lot of it. I mean, I really had dark circles under my eyes. And when she was studying anthropology at UH, she was, you know, reading the book about the anthropology of dairy industry. And she's like, well, you know, I'm part Native American, and she was like, well, that means you're probably lactose intolerant. And I always knew I was like, but I was buying the healthiest whey protein.
The goat milk, or, yeah.
You know, what I thought was the best product, and this is, again, simultaneously listening to your videos, but I still thought whey protein was clean enough. Mm-hmm. And then the second I got off the whey and did 100% hemp, at that time I did rice, and now I don't do rice anymore, but I like more hemp. And more algae. I like more of the 50-50 tablets. That's more most of my protein now, and quinoa and chia. But as soon as I flushed the dairy whey protein, my eyes, the circles went away. I mean, I still have some, but...
Not compared.
It was like a facelift. It was like, oh my gosh, your dark circles have gone away, and even more digestion improvement. I used to always get congested and have sinus issues.
You don't have any pimples. You don't have any blushing. You have nothing.
And I used to break down a lot more. I still break out every once in a while. Usually it's like razor burn or something. But yeah, all those things clear up a lot.
All the mucus.
Yeah, and it's you're just like, wow, I didn't know I could feel this good. And then I find myself amazed at how little I eat. And it's like, I'm not hungry. I mean, we worked out 2 times the other day, and before we came here, we did a little like a coconut fast just to like clean out our system even more. And I'm thinking, you know, oh gosh, I'm already pretty lean. I'm going to be tired, you know. Mm. And then just coming here, it's just like learning the next level. Like, wow, you think you're clean, but now you're taking it to the next level. And the energy level, I was shocked. I mean, I really was shocked in how much energy I was able to maintain. Because before I would eat quinoa or something, you know, quinoa, nori, avocado. But just going that little bit of a fast to clean up.
Yeah, no, you're going
more
up to that next level.
Yeah, it's like, I was amazed. So.
And you know, there's a whole, as you feel, you've gone through a lot of the simple, what you look at right now, it's very simple of the changes you made, just because you've done them. But at that time, they were work. It's just like going to third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade. You graduate sixth grade and you're in ninth grade. You look back and go, well, how simple though that was? Simple. So right now, look at yourself as like you're an 11th grader, and you just graduated from 10th, and now you're going into this other layer, okay? And this next layer is going to really, really change the way, you know, because you got to get rid of a lot of the baggage I think you lost 50 pounds. That's a lot of baggage. You lost 20 pounds. That's a lot of baggage. You remineralized your system with real food, not fake food. And a lot of people say, well, how do I even know if it's fake food or real food? Take your clothes off and look in the mirror. All that baggage is, you know, like I always sometimes tell people, you have Dunlap's disease. And what's Dunlap's disease? Dunlapped over your belt. Okay, it's sort of like a joke when I was like 12 years old. Hey, Nick, look, that guy's got Dunlap's disease. And this is all the food that can't be assimilated. So when you start, like I notice you got all these veins in your arm, you know, I mean, you're way leaner, okay, than 50 pounds. You didn't have a vein in your arm. You know what I mean?
You couldn't see it. It was everything, there.
It was there, but everything's hiding. And yeah. So the veins that you have just show the amount of clarity and or the amount of cleanliness that your system's flowing. So 50 pounds overweight, and if you were 50 pounds overweight for the next 20 years, could you imagine the cardiovascular, arterial sclerosis, the disease that you would have been looking at getting coming forward? And what you did was just basically change your whole life by manipulating your own self. And so this is what I'm really trying to get across to everybody too. Everybody can do this themselves. This is not something that, you know, and that is impossible to do. It's very simple. You go at your own pace. And there are all these different grades and levels, and don't go so fast. Just go at your own pace and try to get a companion if you can to be able to help yourself with this. And like I said, I had a friend, his name is Mark Daniels. I've known him for 35 years, and we've done a lot of terrain modification over time. When we used to eat 5 pounds of meat, he used to eat 5 pounds of meat, and I used to eat about 3. Stuff it down me and think it was good, because the same thing. I read Education of a Bodybuilder. Arnold used to eat a whole turkey at a time, okay? 30 eggs at a time. So I tried to go ahead and follow a lot of things that I thought that made sense, but all it did was really clog me up. And so it took me years. So the younger group of people, really, they look at the older group of people and they say, just like, you know, anybody says, I don't want to get like those people. So the mean group of the group I like to work with are 18 to 33 year old, because they're still very curious on staying healthy because they're not sick yet. And the last thing they want to do is get like all the rest of the people. Remember, there are 50 million diabetics, sort of weird. And the younger you are to get on any of these naturalistic programs, just the more you want to go to school and learn. How could you go to school and learn if your brain's clogged up with junk? Do you feel that you have more capacity right now, clarity? You know, what would be the things that you'd want to tell anybody, both you guys, for anybody that's watching this, for inspiring them to jump on the wagon to get healthy?
Gosh.
I think kind of this is kind of full circle, because it really kickstarted seeing that video of you about a year and a half ago, and it's like to be now talking to you, and it's like, so if someone sees this and they're at where I was, you know, 5 years ago or 3 or whatever, that wherever they're at, that, you know, the steps are laid out, it's doable, it's logical, it's more affordable compared to buying at maybe, you know, the normal store, and it can be done, you know, like you said, get a partner, it's so much easier with a partner. And, you know, if you can, you know, and I also think about like my stepfather and also relatives that maybe have already passed on, that, gosh, you know, if they had this program, my grandfather had this program, maybe he would still be alive, and maybe my stepfather is alive because of this program. So if someone has someone they care about at home, or they just love themselves enough to be like, I want to be there for my kids, or, you know, that's powerful stuff. I mean, that's changing your life. That's really, and that's free. It's not like you're saying, hey, I'm going to give you the secrets to health and fitness for X amount of dollars. And, you know, you don't have to buy the products, but it seems to me that they're the best I found that to be available. And I've looked at a lot of different companies, and, you know, that's a lot. I mean, that's a lot you can do with your life.
I tell people, you know what you have to pay? Pay attention.
Yeah.
That's it. And then not everything that we're saying may be 1,000% true to your mind. And we may change things in 2 or 3 years to make it, because it's a work in progress. I'm just a student. You guys are students.
Yeah.
We all help each other progress, and whatever really that you feel, once you get to a certain layer, what you really want is other people to be able to come across this threshold, because they're exactly where you know where you're at. You got to make a leap here. And if you don't have the information at your fingertips, and that's why there's hundreds of videos, hundreds, for people to watch. There's hundreds, and those are not only the ones that I've done, but there's hundreds of documentaries. I'm actually putting together a book right now that actually has taken a lot of the documentaries and made it so instead of watching, you know, Big Bang Theory at night or Three's Company or watching the news or whatever it would be, which would be normal to you, spend an hour every night and watch something that's going to grow you. And it's going to change the way you think, of course, but, you know, that's the reason being why a lot of times we're not where we should be, because we do need to change the way we think. Okay, that was a nice little interview. I just wanted to show everybody that these changes are very easy to grasp, especially if you see other people that have already gone through the rabbit hole. And of course, where they're at today, they're not happy. I'm not happy where I'm at because I'm at another grade. So I'm so glad to see other people basically that are really wanting to become more human. Because once you get to a certain level, you guys are already healthy. Now you're into this evolution to expand what we do know and helping out with this information really to make it so it's more logical. Because that's all this program is. It's just logical. I call it biological. It's not so much my program or any program. It's just a logical program. We're just connecting the dots to make this illogical world seem a little more logical. Anything you want to say before we go do our insanity class and sweat?
We'll have a fun time.
She's wearing her beautiful crystals there, and these crystals really do harmonize you, and they do. These are just little tools that I get these made in Brazil, and they do help you stay in more tune. And little things that actually can help you, give them a try. They're all very, very inexpensive to do. And I always tell people, you know, if you don't have, because a lot of people that are going to watch this video, they may be from the UK or they may be from other parts of the world that may not be able to eat some of the different foods. And the foods that we're having, they're just heirloom. An heirloom where we live in the United States is really hard to find. An heirloom just means that they have not been hybridized. They haven't had their seeds taken out of them yet, which is genetically modified sterile. They're naturally the way they came from nature. Tomatoes this big, okay? Apples are this big. A hybridized apple is this big. One, let's say a genetically modified, here's a regular orange, a Valencia orange, seedless, a navel orange. They're all different types. So we're just trying to get back to the original form of food, and you'll see what happens when you get back to that. And if you can find it on your own, I always tell people to see if you could use local foods from your farmer's market and really, you know, make friends with some of your local people there that you know that are putting their love and energy into the foods that they're bringing to the farmer's market. Try to stay away from buying stuff from the health food store that you really don't know where it came from. Try to go to the farmer's markets and meet people that you know that's why they're doing this, is because this is their life. They love growing food. Aquaponic food, this is one of the things that you learned about. You could have learned about other things, but look what you're learning right now. You're learning about things that actually are very interesting towards naturalistic lifestyles or just evolutionary lifestyles. So I think we're good. And like I said, anything you guys want to add to the
just
end of the...
Thank you for having us out to your beautiful retreat. It's been a fantastic week, just about almost a week. So it's been really good.
I know, that was fast, too. Yeah. Okay, there we go. Jacob and Julie from Oahu, and they are going to keep in contact because I really like these people too, because there's not many people. Once you get into this layer, See, I look at these guys as teachers now. They're not like a lot of the people that I meet that just want to sort of get healthy and learn a few things. These guys are really learning things, and I watch them. He doesn't have to talk to people about inspiration, and that's what happens when you actually know that what you're doing, you don't think you know, but you know what you're doing is something that is beneficial for other people you want to share with them. So that's what I see you guys now, is you've got this disease now, like I've got. You can't shut your mouth anymore because you know that what you're doing has efficacy to it. And as a doctor, efficacy just means efficacy is there's a form of truth. So, all right, there we go. We'll see you next time. Big Island Retreats. And wow.